Minnesota ideas, training, and business are flowing to a country on the other side of the world, Pakistan. People with ties to our state are also playing a big role in advocacy there to help strengthen human rights and improve the quality of life for the Pakistani people.
And 5 Eyewitness News reporter Mark Albert recently spent 2 weeks there discovering Minnesota in Pakistan.
In the rural hillsides outside Pakistan's capital sits a round building that shapes lives, molded by a woman whose own views were cast at the University of Minnesota.
I always say, in USA, my village is Minnesota.
Your village is Minnesota?
Yes, yes.
After getting her bachelor's, master's, and doctorate in Minneapolis, Fazia Saeed returned to her native Pakistan to launch the human rights group Mahagir.
We wanted the center to be in this place.
She asked her sister, Malia Hussein, back in Minnesota, to join her.
Do you feel a personal calling to be here?
Actually, yes.
Together, the sisters have pressed for legislation in Pakistan's parliament to prevent sexual harassment, domestic violence, and bondage labor. And they train young people in leadership and more during 8-week camps here in the countryside. But it has come at a price. In a nation with conservative militants.
What you're teaching would make them angry?
Yes, it would.
Would it put you at risk?
It would, yes.
Do you worry about your safety?
No.
Why not?
Well, you do the work that you think is important and it needs to be done. You have to believe in what you're doing. Otherwise, you don't do it.
Even in the face of a government whose position towards such groups can seemingly change direction at any time.
They treat us as if we are not citizens expressing our voices, but as if we are troublemakers. Okay, that kind of impression.
Are you a troublemaker?
No, we do rock the boat, yes, but not to create trouble.
Some advocacy, though, can be too much for Pakistan's rulers. Today is the birthday of the Prophet Muhammad. It's a national holiday, and here in Pakistan, the government is apparently so afraid of protests or attacks, it has shut down the cell phone network. No service, no phone calls, no text messages, no mobile email.
My name is Mark Albert.
So I pressed the government's chief spokesman about it. Pakistan's Minister of Information told us his country turned off cell networks only in certain cities for limited times after specific information of violence to prevent a bomb triggered by a cell phone, for example, and not, he said, to stifle democracy.
So we avoided terrorist activity over there in those areas. That's very simple, it's very logical.
Is Pakistan intolerant to dissent?
It is not the issue of dissent. Pakistan is very tolerant.
YouTube is also blocked here. The government says it's to prevent certain videos from inciting violence and that it's the people's will to block the site. But we found no one who supported the move. Blocking fraud is what Colin Cram shines a light on. The Gustavus graduate from an Iowa border town was at this Islamabad conference to promote a new fraud prevention hotline.
That's sort of revolutionary here.
Cram works for the U.S. Agency for International Development, growing what he likes to call grassroots diplomacy.
It sort of sounds like you're trying to empower these groups to be able to advocate for themselves.
Exactly. Ultimately, we are empowering people. That's the name of the game. We're really trying to sell our ability to bolster civil society in Pakistan.
During the 2 weeks we were in Pakistan on a U.S. State Department-sponsored journalism exchange program, we also found people with Minnesota connections thriving in business there. Minnesota Entrepreneurs in Pakistan, Thursday at 10. And right now you can check out a slideshow and web extras, along with a look at how challenging it can be to report in Pakistan. It's all at KSDP.com.
And you're not sparing those officials over there bringing your hard questioning all the way to the other side of the world, huh?
Well, these are questions a lot of regular Pakistanis told us they want answers to. They get the official government line, and they wanted those questions answered, and so did we.
Do you get a little break because you're an American there asking those questions? A Pakistani journalist probably wouldn't ask the same question.
Well, that was an audience with the Minister of Information, and that is not granted to everybody that goes there. We certainly felt as though in an official delegation that we had certain access to people that we might not have ordinarily, and we wanted to take advantage of that and ask the questions that were at the top of everybody's mind.
Yeah. Mark, thank you.